I'm Ariana.
And I'm Brandon.
And we are conducting an experiment to evaluate how fast do people react to a falling object.
We are going to put a ruler above a person's hand, and we are not going to let them know when we will drop the object.
Therefore, we developed a hypothesis, which is...
Boys will react faster than girls because boys are more competitive and have higher testosterone.
Measure their distance in inches and how, in order to determine how long it took the participants to react.
Here's how it went.
Alright, so now we have collected our data as shown here on our table.
In order to accurately test our hypothesis, we performed the experiment on 10 boys and 10 girls, then recorded their distance in inches of how long it took for them to react.
With yours, sir. As of a graphical representation, we created a box and whiskers graph to display and evaluate our data.
As you can see, the mean or average of the reaction distance for the boys is 7.3, while the mean for the girls is 7.7. This specific evidence proves that, in average, boys react faster than girls.
Using the outlier formula, we have concluded that there are no existing outliers for both boys and girls.
This means that both boys and girls caught the ruler within a small range.
Speaking of the range, the girls was 9.5, which is significantly less than the range of the boys, which is 12.
According to the data, the maximum of both genders, 14 and 14.5, were almost equivalent.
To sum up our research, it is proven that overall boys do react faster than girls.
Based off our data, it is undeniable that girls react slower than boys because boys are more competitive, have higher testosterone level, and have faster reflexes.
However, we must distinguish carefully between boys and girls because their mean was not significantly different.
Yes, their mean was only 0.5 apart in contrast.
The consequence of our research is that since boys are better physically than girls, they will dominate in work fields that require higher physical levels.
Take consideration of the Olympics. Sports that are played by males, for example, boxing and wrestling, projects an extremely higher rate of physical dependence. This physical dependence are acquired more by males than females.
Therefore, we can conclude that our hypothesis was correct.